Everyone, welcome to week two of the ISU Junior Grand Prix 2018. I'm your host, Ted Barton, and this week we're in the charming city of Linz. Linz is the third largest city in Austria. It is located in the northern center of Austria, approximately 30 kilometers south of the Czech border, and is constructed on both sides of the famous river Danube. The population of the city is just over 200,000. Linz is a lively, modern city which has a long and eventful history, and the architecture of its developed city center with the Baroque hot plots is unique, but it merges seamlessly with a beautifully urban lifestyle and exciting cultural scene. Week one in Bratislava produced some remarkable skating in all disciplines. In men, 13-year-old Stephen Gogolev of Canada, in his first Junior Grand Prix event, delivered it all. In ladies, Anna Shcherbakova of Russia, delightful and dominant. In pairs, Anastasia Mishina and Alexander Gelyamov of Russia, brilliant. And in dance, Elizaveta Kudobierdieva and Nikita Nazarov were simply superb and charming. We have four of last year's Junior Grand Prix finalists here this week in Linz. In men, Kamden Polkinen of the United States. In ladies, Alina Korsanaya of Russia. In dance, Marjorie Lajoie and Zachary Laga of Canada. And in pairs, Anastasia Polyanova and Dmitry Sopot of Russia round out perhaps some of the returning favorites from last season. This is week two in Linz. Stories begin to unfold, and it starts right now. Hello everyone and welcome to day three, the final day of competition from Linz, Austria. Beautiful aerial shot of the church on top of the hill. Oh, I didn't even see this footage, it's beautiful. And the Danube down below. And look outside the arena and home to the Junior Grand Prix. The second time in 3 years, Linz has played host to the Junior Grand Prix event. Welcome live inside the building here in Linz. The free dance is coming up. We're going to have a full day of events and competition, starting with the free dance, then on to the pairs, and then finally the ladies' competition, and that will be exciting indeed.
The following competitors may now take the ice for a 5-minute warm-up. From Israel, Alice Rogatnik and Juha Barzak. From China, Cheesy James and Jiangjing Qing. From Australia, Matilda Friend and William Badui. And from Austria, Corinna Huber and Patrick Huber.
I want to welcome our viewers from around the world. And thank you very much for joining us. It's terrific getting messages and emails from viewers in Chile and China and Nepal, Saudi Arabia, Argentina, all over the globe. The sport is popular and growing. And thank you for your joining the Junior Grand Prix. Some terrific skaters, some developing young ones as well. Wide range of abilities on the Junior Grand Prix. Some that could move right into senior and some that are just starting their careers in figure skating. Or remarkably difficult sport, not easily understood how hard it is, because they're always dressed nicely and they have nice music and whatnot, but physically extremely difficult. Really, no other sport has to look good and present themselves well, whether it's going fast or jumping or racing. Make sure to follow us on all the platforms of social media, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter. And for those of you who would like to subscribe to YouTube, if there's a little icon on the bottom right-hand part of your screen that has the ISU logo, just click on that on your computer or your device, and you can register there, subscribe there, because you'll get live updates of new videos that have been uploaded, and also when a competition goes live online. So you'll not miss a minute of the action wherever you are. And a look at the technical panel for the free dance. And I keep calling, calling, and now the judges.
Couples, there is one more minute in your warm-up. Couples, your warm-up has ended. Please clear the ice. On the ice, representing Israel, Alice Rogatnik and Yohar Barzhak.
Alice 15, Yohar also 15. Hometown Kiev in the Ukraine. They're coached and choreographed by Maria Chaika. Skating to the story of chess from the musical soundtrack, Chess. Thank you.
Olympian, who'd be the fool in my position? Once I had dreams, now they're obsessions. Hopes became needs, lovers possessions. Then they move in, oh so discreetly. Slowly at first, smiling too sweetly, I opened doors. They walked right through them, called me their friend. I hardly knew them.
Well, I thought that was very nice for a number of reasons. They were calm and they skated very closely together, which is really nice. Beautiful backs, so the posture was excellent. You know, they need some work on expression, but that's going to come in time. I mean, when you're just starting out in a discipline, to get comfortable to skate with another person as one, when there are two people, it takes time. And just knowing where that person is all the time. But I was really surprised at how close they skated. Here's a look at the twizzles, good unison. Nicely done there. For sure, you know, edges can be deeper, they can skate faster, they can certainly have a little bit more expression, all those types of things. But for where they're starting here, here's a look at the curve lift. Lean away. Oh, great flexibility in the back. Wow. Very nice start to this day of competition. There's a rotational lift. Good ice coverage. That's in at a level two. I mean, some of the elements may have a little bit lower level of difficulty as they're just getting going. But they never made me feel that they were out of control. I enjoyed it very much. There's a stationary, or the choreographed lift, sorry, at the end of the program. Nice event. Smiles all around and the kiss and cry. The job is well done. Feels so good, so nice. And it gets you addicted to the competition and that feeling that you get. Because this sport is so hard. When you skate well, such a
the
great
scores,
high.
Please.
Take a look at the scores for the free dance.
Alice Bogatnik and Iha Barzak have
55.57. They are the first team out. This is the free dance score and a total competition score
of 93.62. And brings them into the
first place.
On the ice, representing China, Zizi Chen and Chang Xing Xing.
Zizi 16, Chang Yang also 16, both from Harbin, China. This is their first unit Grand Prix season. They're coached by Zhen Chen Zhen, choreographed by Jamie White. Skating their free dance to Caught Out in the Rain by Beth Hart and Another One Bites the Dust by Queen.
I'm already there, and it ain't nobody's business. Every time he walks out the door, I wonder if he's ever coming. But love the taste of danger, babe.
Zizi Chen and Chang Xing Xing.
Well, it looked like Zizi had fun during that program. Fist pump in the air at the end. Well, this is a new team, a young team. Just learning the sport and the art of ice dance. got some work on the individual skating skills. There's some, certainly a range of movement as well. Here's a look at the stationary lift at the beginning, very nice. The level three, the plus Dewey, that was nice work. Right off the top. One of the things that I notice is that the range of movement with her upper body, with the choreography, certainly can be extended. There's the twizzles, good ice coverage to begin with, a little out of synchronization. That first set was level three, and now the second set was level four. There is a minus grade of execution, which means there was a small reduction of the score for quality. Back on that topic, dance has got so much to do with the movement to the music, to the phrasing of the movement. You have to use your arms and your upper body and your head and everything. And that range has got to be very big. We're like that, those movements right there, they were nice, but not big. Lower in the knee, further reach with the arms, just those little details. Straight line lift near the end of the program. And that will come as they feel more secure together as a team and as individual skaters. They'll feel confident, hey, I can reach further here. I can extend this further. I can make it bigger. Just takes time. Lots of mileage.
The scores, please. Xi Jishen and Jiang Jingli, excuse me, Jiang Qingqing, have earned 60.84 points
for the free dance.
This gives first them a combined their total of 100.
Total competition score 100.20, and that puts them currently in the first place.
On the ice, representing Australia, Matilda Friend and William Badoui.
Matilda 19, William 20, both from Sydney. They're coached by Monica McDonald and John Dung. Choreographed by Nikolai Morozov. They're skating to Lady Gaga selection.
Matilda Friend and William Badoui.
A beautiful piece of music, and there were times they really connected to each other and to the music beautifully. They have nice, deep, soft edges. Drifted apart in some places. But the skating skills are strong. They look good. We'll take a look at some of the elements. Look here at the entrance into the twizzles. Nice and close here, good synchronization. Here's the change of position, the leg. She looked like she was just starting to lose the balance, but kept it together. Yeah, nicely done. There's a level 3 and a 4 on the twizzles with a plus 0.51 of GOE. And there's a straight line lift. Level 2 currently in the system. Pretty stable, nicely done. And the curve lift to level 4. Small GOE plus. Choreographic lift at the end of the program. Nicely done. Just more mileage, more detail, more speed, certainly more speed. But well done.
Matilda Friend and William Badoui have earned 64.
Matilda and William free dance score of 64.38. That's first in the free dance with a total competition score of 109.43, and they are overall currently in first place.
I don't get my birthday present.
Smiles and joy, and the kiss and cry came a long ways.
Representing Austria,
here we go.
Karina Huba and Patrick Huba.
Karina and Patrick, both 15 years old. This is their first Junior Grand Prix season. Skating to Juliet's Dream from Romeo and Juliet.
Thank you.
Corina Huba and Patrick Huba.
Well, look, good job this morning, brother and sister team. Skating to Romeo and Juliet, which had a good rhythm to it. Like it was, you know, this is a young team. They need to work on their basic skating skills and skating together. It takes thousands and thousands of hours to just naturally know where your partner is. And they're early on in those thousands and thousands of hours required. Here's a look at the straight line lift. This is well done. It's a level 3, small plus GOE. Here's a look into the twizzles. That was nice and close. Well done on that first set. A little extra turn on Karina's part. They're in at level 3 and level 3 for both sides. You know, I think it was very steady for them. They did what they had trained to do, and now they'll go back and train to make it better and stronger and faster. And as they grow and spend those thousands of hours together, it'll all tighten up, all get better. This sport takes so long to develop. I know I wasn't very talented myself, but I was a hard worker. Nicely done.
The scores, please. Corina Huba and Patrick Huba have earned 49.06
in the free dance. That's fourth.
That gives them a combined total of
and a total score for the competition of 80.82. That's also fourth overall. Good experience for this young team at home. Get a feel for what the Junior Grand Prix level is. Watch the other skaters, learn a little bit.
For a 5-minute warm-up. From Germany, Charisse Mate and Maximilian Pfisterer. From France, Lou Terrain and Noé Perron.
And a look at the standings so far after the first four teams.
Jocelyn Haynes and James Kosuda. Also from the United States of America, Sophia Elder and Christopher Elder.
Yeah. You can email me directly at jgpbarton@gmail.com, jgpbarton@gmail.com. Love to learn how you got involved in skating, or do you skate yourself? What other events do you watch? We're thrilled that you're watching the Junior Grand Prix. When did you get into watching the Junior Grand Prix? How did that come about? All those stories help us understand our viewers from around the world, and the reach, and how it all got started. Once again, jgpbarton@gmail.com. Periodically, I try to answer some of the questions. If you have questions, I'll answer them online or, you know, through an email. We'll do the best we can to engage in some back and forth with our viewers and
couples. There's one more minute in
chat.
Your warm-up.
And there's a look at the start order for Group 2, just finishing up their warm-up. And follow us on all the social media platforms, Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, and Twitter. You'll see the interviews, the videos, all the news around the world of the ISU Junior Grand Prix and the other ISU events as well.
This warm-up has ended. Please clear the ice. On the ice, representing Germany, Charisse Mathé and Maximilian Pfisterer.
Charisse, 17, Maximilian, 21. She was born in Berlin, he in Munich, second junior Grand Prix season. Skating their free dance to "This World Will Remember Me." How about a dance? And "This World Will Remember Us," all by Frank Wildhorn and Don Black.
The men in this town live and die and are forgotten, and it doesn't seem to scare them. I can't wait to get away, away from the drought and the homeless and the hungry, where they talk about foreclosures every hot and dusty day. I don't intend to waste my life. I'll have wealth and fame. Everyone will know my name.
Pull three jobs. What does that mean?
What do you think it means? We are wasted around here. We're too good for this place. We weren't born to live and die in Texas. This is my plan. There's no plan B. And this world will remember me.
baby.
Thanks to you, Bonnie, babe, I can make plans again. I got lots of reasons to keep living. Yes, through that love can set you free, and this world will remember me.
Every place that we go,
Charisse Mathé and Maximilian Pfisterer.
Well, that was kind of a fun free dance. Lots of energy, personality, some nice elements as well. Take a look at some of those elements. Here's the entrance into the twizzles. Good speed, good unison. Nice and close. Some steps in between. This is a new rule. It's allowed to have some nice steps, connecting steps. There's a little bit out of synchronization there. Back on in the third set. Wow, that was nice. Level 4 and level 3. A small plus in the quality department, the GOE. Position, establish, out, straight line lift, 3, some nice steps and edges, circular steps. Nice entrance into the spin, into the stationary lift. Let's see what happens at the end of this. That's okay there so far. Joe just lost his balance. And the choreographic lift near the end of the program, or at the end.
Maximilian Pfisterer have earned
for Charisse and Maximilian 67.96 for the free dance. That's first so far. A total competition score of 113.39. And that puts them overall in the first place.
On the ice, representing France, Lou Thorin and Noé Perron.
Lou was 16 and Noah 17. He was born in Belfort.
Lutheran and Neue Peron.
As I mentioned from Bratislava last week, I always enjoy watching the skaters from France because they always take an innovative, unique, and different approach. You have to really appreciate that creativity and that effort to be different. It's certainly not anything traditional, always experimenting, exploring and growing. Still, it's skating. You need good technique and the good skating skills, all those things. But the creative side, they're always reaching out.
Points 69
for their free dance. That's the first place. Total competition score 116.94. They're currently overall in first place.
On the ice, representing the United States of America, Jocelyn Haynes and James Kasuda.
Jocelyn, 16, born in China. James, 20, born in Buffalo, New York. This is their first Junior Grand Prix season. They're skating to a collection of pieces from Hans Zimmer and the soundtrack, Pearl Harbor. Thank you.
Jocelyn Haynes and James Kasuda.
Well, you have to admit they poured their emotion and their soul into that program. One of the things I really, really appreciated was the great depth of their edges. They take a risk, they bend those knees really low, and they're on a very steep, deep curve, and it's beautiful. It's one of their strengths. Take a look at some of those elements. It was a good program, it was emotional, powerful, great speed. Look at the depth of the edge right there, right in there, nice and soft, the knees. Look at the depth right in there. Such a tight curve, good flow. And they did that throughout the program. So they did not skate on flat edges. They were always on a good lean. Look at the upper body turned over by Jocelyn. Little bit, but look at the balance here. That is not easy to have the girl, have the lady change the position while you're on one foot and not waver that free leg. That was great stability, very well done. Rotational lift at the end of the program, lots of movement, and very hard for the boy to keep that, those turns rotating smoothly while the lady is changing positions. And a choreographic lift at the end of the program. Really nicely done. Lots of areas to work on for sure. All the teams have that. But I think they did everything they planned beautifully today. Scores for Jocelyn and James. 76.19. That's first in the free dance. Well done. Powerful and emotional program. And the total competition score of 123.02. That puts them overall currently into first place. Well done.
On the ice, representing the United States of America, Sophia Elder and Christopher Elder.
Sophia, 15, Christopher, 17, both born in Louisville, Kentucky. They were coached by Kelly Morris Adair and Donnie Adair for the past 9 years, with the addition of Igor Spielband this year.
Sophia Elder and Christopher Elder.
That was beautiful.
I was completely engaged in that performance from the first note. I thought they did a beautiful job performing right to the music, with the feeling of it, phrasing the movement and the music matched for the most part. Some good elements, some unique. Here's a good speed. We'll jump into the twizzles. I've been corrected, the twizzles are judged by the girl for the first set, that's the score, and then the second set for the man, or the score, sorry. So the twizzles here, there's a 4 for the lady and a 3 for the man. There's a pickup on the, that's not easy, over the shoulders, down into the spread eagle, change the position. It's a different type of difficulty to a pair lift, for sure. There's a lot of movement around the body of the band. The stable position is so critical. Here's some nice 1 foot work in their circular steps. Choreography, some emotional reach out, engagement into the program. Rotational lift at the end of the program. Got a little bit off balance there on 1 foot, and that last rotation almost went too far back, but saved it. Really enjoyed this program. I really enjoyed the performance. Yes.
The scores, please. Sophia Elder and Christopher Elder have earned
77.90 in the free dance. That's first.
That gives them a
nice score.
Total of 127.
Total competition score 127.48. They're at this point of the competition with 5 teams yet to come. They're in first place.
We will now have a break for the resurfacing of the ice and continue the competition.
And there's a look at the standings so far after two groups. Sophia and Christopher of the United States, 127.48. Jocelyn and James of the United States, 123.02. Lou Noah of France, 116.9 for your top three. 5 more teams yet. We're going to take a short break for the ice resurfacing. You're watching live coverage of the ISU Junior Grand Prix Week 2 from Linz, Austria. This is the third and final day of this competition. One more group coming up. Stay with us.
because of
the way you broke my heart.
Someone new. Hope life is beautiful. You were the light for me to find my truth. I just wanna say thank you.
Leaving to find my soul. Told her I had to go. And I know it ain't pretty when our hearts get
Welcome back, everyone. Linz, Austria, day three of competition. Last group of dancers about to take to the ice for the warm-up. Standings of the first two groups.
Couples, there is 1 minute left in this warm-up.
We are the same thing.
Couples, your warm-up has ended. Please clear the ice. On the ice, representing Canada, Natalie D'Alessandro and Bruce Waddell.
Natalie, 14, Bruce, 16, both from Toronto. This is their first Junior Grand Prix season together, coached by Andrew Hellam and Siobhan Karam. Skating the free dance to Malaguena and the Carmen Suite.
Natalie D'Alessandro and Bruce Waddell.
Well, you could see at the end, Bruce, now the words, well, not bad. Well, I think that was, like, really good. So, at least watching it, anyways, maybe he felt, okay, that was pretty good. That was great. Dramatic, powerful, good skating edges, good speed, flow over the ice. They didn't back off of anything. They were pushing the edge, pushing the limit. Makes it so much more dramatic. Might have been little technical things here. I'm not a judge of dance for sure. But an overall performance, really very nicely done. Good start to the season. Here's the Twizzles. First set score goes to the girl, the lady. And next, second set here, just a little out sync. Not bad though, very nice and close. Good range of movement. Talked about that a little earlier with some of the other teams, but the range of their reach and their body and their arms extends way past. There's a nice just 1 foot free turn to on the dismount of that lift. Just a small detail, but nice quality. There's a nice slides across the ice. Always risky, of course, their entrance into their spin. Beautiful. Camel spin, matching free leg. Very nice. Pick up on the rotational lift. The job for the man really is to travel across the ice in this whipping and turning frenzy to make it look so simple and easy and smooth and not have any thing pulled him off center. It's a sign of a good partner when the lady is changing positions. You keep the stability and the smoothness of the turns. Arabian, middle of some steps. Natalie goes into a layback, spread eagle by Bruce.
The scores, please.
Good job, indeed. Andrew Hallam, the coach, and the kissing card. Let's look at the free dance scores. 84.97. Big nod of approval by coach Andrew Hallam. That's first in the free dance, and total competition score of 135.42. Thumbs up on that. And they're currently in first place overall in the competition. Four teams still to come.
On the ice, representing Italy, Sara Campanini and Francesco Riva.
Sara, 15, Francesco, 18, both from Milan. This is their first Junior Grand Prix season. Their coach and choreograph, Matteo Zani, skating to the music. Be Italian.
Thank you.
Sara Campanini and Francesco Riva.
Oh, what a great piece of music. Very sultry and aggressive and powerful and fast. You got to keep up with it and do those technical elements at the same time. Not an easy job for sure. Let's take a look at some of the elements. There's a rotational lift right off the top. Good pickup over the shoulders, back into the position. Good speed, rotation down the ice. Nice. It's a level four with a plus GOE, means plus points for quality. There's the entrance into the twizzles. Maybe a little further apart than they would like. Close the gap a little bit here. Both get a level four, both the man and the lady. And some of the step sequence. Sign of a good dance team is when they're turning and they go to grab each other's hand, it's right there. They don't have to grasp. Nice slow dismount on that lift to go right with the music. Straight lift number, level four. And the choreographed lift at the end of the program.
Sara Campanini and Francesco Riva.
Well, the score is 79.52. That's second so far in the free dance. For Sara and Francesco, take a look at the overall scores. 133.61 for the competition. Sara and Francesco currently in second place overall. Three teams get to skate.
On the ice, representing Canada, Marjorie Lajoie and Zachary Lega.
Marjorie, 17, born in Boucherville, Quebec. Zachary, 19, born in Greenfield Park, Quebec. This is the fourth Junior Grand Prix season. They're coached and choreographed by Marie-France Debray, Patrice Lauzon, Roman Hagenauer, and Pascal Denis. Skating the free dance to the Warsaw Concerto.
Thank you.
Marjorie LaJoy and Zachary Lega.
Well, even though I'm watching this on the monitor, we're inside the rink. I have to tell you, I had chills. The change of pace and the change of mood and the change of emotion that they showed and demonstrated in that was so sophisticated. This is a different team than last year. They've always been good. They've always been good. But they're starting to enter the category of can be great. It's risky and difficult on all the knee slides, but it adds to the drama. There's a look at the stationary lift, 1 foot, just flying. Marjorie just flying around in a beautiful position. The twizzle so fast, you don't necessarily see that speed, but they're flying down the ice. Some nice steps here. There's another knee slide. It's always risky. Back into the second set. There's a look at some of the side-by-side steps. Marjorie is always, I've watched this young team for the past 3 years. Marjorie's performance level is the highest I've ever seen it. So free. Beautiful rotational lift covers almost the whole length of the ice. That was delightful to watch. Emotional. Just as a fan. It was a great moment. Beautiful. I don't know much about the technical, if there are some items here and there, but I do know about the emotional imprint they left. That was a joy. We'll see the scores in just a second.
The scores, please. Marjorie LaJoy and Zachary Lega have
89.84. For the free dance. Moment nod of approval. Total competition score 153.79. They're currently in first place.
They're first place.
Definitely on the podium. What position? Two more teams to skate.
On the ice, representing Russia, Eva Kutz and Dmitry Mikhailov.
Eva, 17, born in St. Petersburg. Dmitry, 20, born in Moscow, second Junior Grand Prix season.
Shut up.
Eva Kutz and Dmitry Mikhailov.
Oh, no question, Eva and Dmitry are such strong individual skaters, as all the Russian dancers, actually all the Russian skaters are, that's for sure. Not sure they had their best day today. There was some items that were a little bit out of sync, a little bit reaching and struggling on some elements. That doesn't mean anything about the team. They're a good team for sure, but today might have been more of a struggle than they had wished. See some of those elements here. They got great flexibility and strength. Look at the speed across the ice. There's a pickup into the curve. That's so beautifully done, so easily handled. Up over the shoulders, back down. That was really nice. We'll jump into the twizzles. Little bit of sync. She lost a little bit of balance, but she hung in there. Good fight to stay in the set. Got it back on track. A little bit off on the third, but not badly. This is the lift that caused some issue. He missed the hold there. Started to lose his balance on the turns. Had to just bring this lift down so it didn't go all the way down. Try to save it. That was one of the problems. But a good young team. Lots yet to come from them.
The scores, please.
The scores for Eva and Dmitry, 84.34 in the free dance. That's third so far.
This gives them a combined
and a total competition
of
score,
142.97. Into the second place.
At this point, they're second overall.
On the ice, representing Russia, Sofia Shevchenko and Igor Ermenko.
Sofia, 16 from Moscow. Igor, 21 from Rostov-on-Don. Third junior Grand Prix season. They're coached by Irina Zhuk, Alexander Shvinin, and choreographed by Alina Samarskaya. This is the last couple in the free dance.
Thank you.
Another team with such great skating skills, pushing the limits, more of a little bit of an abstract type of program. Not so much storytelling or emotional, unique, different, innovative. Take a look at some of the elements. Some nice edge work right in front of the judges off the top of the program. Good turns, soft knees, carry that flow all the way down the ice on one foot. That's quality. Nicely done. Here's the entrance into the twizzles. First set looked pretty good. Sophia lost her balance just a bit there. It wasn't a major problem. Twizzles were two for her and four for him. His dance moves coming towards the judges. Full commitment to the movement and the choreography. They could do that because such strong individual skaters. There's never a thought of, will I lose my balance? They're on top and controlled all the time. Here's the pickup. A little shaky on, the toe picks there. You can see some snow fly up. You carry a lot of flow through that lift. That was not the best for him. Curve lift level 3. And a straight line level 4. This was nice and not easy. But overall should be a good, strong score.
The scores, please. Sofia Shevchenko and Igor Eremenko.
94.44. Oh, the coach is happy. That's all the skaters.
In the free dance.
And they're first in the free dance.
Combined total of 158.70
for first place overall in the competition. And a look at the final results. Sophia and Igor from Russia, 158.70. Marjorie
this
and Zachary of Canada, 153.79. And Neva and Dmitry of Russia, 142.97. Your top three. And a look at the rest of the field. And a look at the rest of the schedule for today. The pairs free skating takes to the ice at 1300 hours here in Linz. And the ladies free program a little bit later this afternoon. That'll be exciting at 1530. It says 1545. It'll be 1530 local time here in Linz. And a look at the rest of the schedule. We move on to Kaunas, Lithuania next week, and then on to Richmond, Canada, suburb of Vancouver, September 12th to 15th, on to Ostrava, Czech Republic, the 26th to 29th of September, and then to Ljubljana, Slovenia, October 3rd to 6th, Yerevan, Armenia, wraps up the Junior Grand Prix, October 10th, 13th, and then the granddaddy of them all, the Junior and Senior Grand Prix Final, December 6th to 9th in Vancouver, Canada. That concludes our coverage of the free dance. We'll be back with the Paris Free program, so join us in just a few moments.